a simple melody. Meld in the three other parts and you find instant happiness. Barber shoppers know this, and they'll prove it anytime, anywhere. On a rooftop. In a railroad yard. On the street. Back on the farm. Yes, sometimes even at work. You'll find barbershop quartets singing in front of a barbershop. Sometimes, even policemen say, "How do you do?" And if a barbershopper can't locate three other men, he'll find 30 just so long as he can sing. Because that's what it's all about, singing. That's what two men in Tulsa wanted to do back in 1938, sing. So Owen Cash, he's in the left, and Rupert Hall wrote a letter and became the founder and co-founder of SPEV-SQSA. In the letter, they simply asked some of their friends and acquaintances to join them to sing some of the old songs. 25 men came to that first meeting back on April 11th, 1938, and they sang in quartets, in octets, gang singing. They sang with such gusto that others heard them, including newspaper reporters. "What's this all about?" asked the reporters. Replied Cash in his best tongue-in-cheek manner, "This is a meeting of the Society for the Preservation and Propagation of Barbershop Quartet Singing in the United States." And the society was on its way. For the reporter told his paper, and the paper told the National Wire Service. The rush was on by every bathroom, tenor, lead, baritone, and bass in the country. So rapid was the society's growth that the very next year it was able to put on a full-fledged contest and convention in Tulsa, Oklahoma. The winners of the first contest were a quartet from nearby Bartlesville, Oklahoma, who called themselves, perish the thought, the Barflies. Everyone had so much fun in Tulsa that they decided to do it again. And what better place than New York City, where the World's Fair was on? The citizens of Manhattan turned out in droves to see the Flatfoot Four from Oklahoma City walk off with top honors. St. Louis was the site of the 1941 get-together, and Oklahoma, where it all started, continued to dominate the championship, this time with the Cordbusters. In 1942, other states were out to break the Oklahoma hold on the championship. The site this time, Grand Rapids, Michigan. One of the first in the scene was founder O.C. Cash and his quartet, the Okey Four. Also on hand was International President Hal Staub from what is now the Northeastern District. Over 5,000 people watched the finals in the Grand Rapids Civic Auditorium and saw, finally, the Oklahoma jinx broken. For the new champions came from Chicago, the Elastic Four. The convention in 1943 in Chicago opened amid many wartime restrictions, but there was still room for song, and John Hanson and his Corn Belt Chorus proved again that where there's a worthy cause, you'll find barbershoppers. In this case, a war bond rally in the midst of the Windy City. And windy it was. Some quartets, as a matter of fact, had some pretty hair-raising experiences. Braving the elements, too, were the members of the board of directors. Well, then, as now, conventions mean meetings as well as singing. These are the men who were laying the foundation back in 1943 for us to enjoy our hobby today. Progress was also being made in 1943 with the judging system. Or if you're going to have a competition, you must have judges. These were the nine on hand in 1943. They listened to and judged no less than 40 quartets. These were the aristocrats, with past international president Norm Rathard on the left. In those days, advertising was allowed. Note the Whiz candy makers from Bloomington, Illinois. Perennial favorites and perennial second place winners, the Kansas City Barber Polecats, later the Serenaders. And how's that for stage presence? Some fellows even sang in front of a barber shop. These are the unheard of four from Muskegon, Michigan. The 1943 champs, another Chicago quartet, the Four Harmonizers. By 1944, travel restrictions were pretty tight throughout the nation, and some quartets had difficulty getting to Detroit for the convention. These are the Main Streeters and Frank Rice trying to hitch a ride. But everyone eventually arrived, including founder O.C. Cash and his daughter Betty. So did international treasurer Joe Stern. And if you think things look black in the background, it's no wonder. For Joe reported to the board that the treasury amounted to about $16. But if Nero fiddled while Rome burned, Joe just played the piano. Please, Mr. Stern, have you no concern? The international board was indeed concerned, made plans in Detroit to strengthen the society's financial structure. But the conventioner was much more interested in hearing singing than the society's financial plight. 50 quartets were on hand to vie for top laurels. One was the Main Streeters. They must have gotten that ride, finally. Here are four fellows who were taking no chances on losing out on the transportation. They carried their tickets right in their hatbands. The Travelers from Grand Rapids. Here's a quartet that was a great favorite back in 1944. Always in every contest, the New York Police Quartet. An appropriate name for this group from Saginaw, Michigan, the Slap Happy Chappies. Later to be champs in 1947, the Doctors of Harmony. They had community singing in those days also. Here's John Hanson of the Corn Belt Chorus. Now, the judge's decision. Third place goes to the Westinghouse Quartet. In second, the Misfits. The winners, the Harmony Halls from Grand Rapids, Michigan. And as everyone left the hotel to return to their homes for another year, International President Phil Embry was on hand to see them off. So long. See you back here again in 1945. Well, that's where the convention was in 1945 in Detroit. The reason? Wartime travel restrictions. As a matter of fact, they were so tight that for the first time in the society's history, elimination sessions were held and the field narrowed down to 15 quartets. The elimination sessions were held in four cities across the country: New York, Cleveland, Kansas City, and Chicago. These were held in May, and from them, 15 quartets were chosen to sing in the finals in Detroit. To make sure that judging was uniform at each elimination site, the same four judges were used. These men were Frank Thorne, Joe Stern, Molly Regan, and Carol Pallery. And so to the finals in Detroit. And while the judges were adding up their scores, community singing was led by Carlton Scott. The winners showed here in all their glory, the Misfits from Chicago. At last, the war was over. And in 1946, barbershoppers celebrated with an international convention in Cleveland. The board held sessions under the able direction of Phil Embry. But certainly it was not all work and no play. A distinguished quartet indeed, Treasurer Joe Stern, International President Embry, past International President Hal Staub, and International Secretary Carol Adams. And who's that trying to steal the arrangement? Can it be? yes. None other than our noble founder, O.C. Cash. But most of the singing took place at the auditorium. Here is the Westinghouse Quartet from Pittsburgh. Another Pittsburgh group, the Allen Four, later to become the Pittsburghers. It seems that the big thing to do in 1946 was carry a cane and sway. Here's the Bonanza Four with President-to-be Charlie Merrill on the right. Remember Bill Hess of Barnacle Bill the Sailor fame? That's him on the right with the Gary Harmon airs. The Cliff Dwellers from Oakland County, Michigan. More canes, more sway. It's said that some judges suffered from seasickness before it was all over. But there was some relief. Just get a load of this stage presence. And here's the 1946 way to hit a high tenor note.
I think I hurt myself.
Some even offered a word of praise for a job well done.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And you'll never guess what these fellows are singing. Pop up, you leaven. Even in those days, what to do with your hands on stage was a problem. Shades of things to come. Would you believe the Mid-States Four, 1946 version? And then, of course, if you didn't agree with the judge's decision, well... But it was a great convention, and co-chairman Jim Knife and Maynard Graft congratulated themselves on a job well done. The winners? In fifth spot, the Hilos from Milwaukee. In fourth were the Cordeliers from Rock Island, Illinois. In third, the Doctors of Harmony from Elkhart, Indiana. Second, for the fourth time, the Kansas City Serenaders. The 1946 International Champions, the Garden State Quartet from Jersey City, New Jersey. The convention over, it's homeward bound until 1947 in Milwaukee. And the last ones to leave are the 1942 champs, the Elastic Four, as they pass the biscuits, Mirandy.
Shooting everything in sight. I shot the boys and a dozen Martin boys. Shooting gives a man an appetite.
Four men enjoying themselves singing and entertaining others at the same time. That's what it was all about in 1946. And that's what it's still all about today.